April 12th, I was in Paris, obviously. I was staying at this hotel, the Royal Monceau on Avenue Hoche. What did I do that day? I swam first. I go down, had a swim. Then I have coffee. Then I read three newspapers. I read the New York Times, I read the Guardian from London, and I read the Financial Times. And then I will probably go for a walk. I like the park. Parc Monceau. Then I'll come back and maybe go shopping. I don't know, maybe look for a, you know, a pair of shoes or something. Then I like to go for lunch at Lip, where I order vintage sardines and a glass of Sancerre. And then I have to go to Olympia to do a sound check and rehearse with my musicians. And then I'll go to my dressing room and I'll maybe do some yoga, or I'll sleep, or I meditate, and then it's showtime. So that's my day. I have a routine, and that keeps me sane. So I do more or less the same thing every day in every city. But you know, Paris is special because you have special restaurants, you have great food, you have great shopping, and it's beautiful, so, yeah.
Alors, c'est un grand honneur pour moi d'être ici ce soir. Dans cette salle historique, je sais l'histoire est formidable. Jacques Brel, Edith Piaf, Yves Montand, Plastic Bertrand. Ça a plein pour moi. Je l'aime.
Plastic Bertrand, I love that record, Ça plein pour moi. It's a classic punk record, very early punk record, and I think it's a masterpiece. So I wanted to honor him. I didn't know that joke was in the DVD, but obviously it is. So.
No matter what they say, be yourself. No matter what they say, be yourself.
One of my favorite records was recorded there. It's a jazz pianist called Thelonious Monk, live at the Olympia Paris. So when I was a teenager, I played that record every night when I did my homework. So I had this thing in my head about Thelonious Monk playing at Olympia. I feel that all the music that's been played in that hall is somehow in the cells of the walls. It's somehow there, and you feel you're part of a tradition. That's important. It's a good feeling. You know, Miles Davis played there, the Beatles, Jimi Hendrix, and all the great French legends. So you feel you're part of that, and that's important.
If we get back, we'll tell our tales to all of those who listen. The might have been, the chances lost, the monies that went missing.
I think to be a traveling musician and to have a family is a difficult balance to achieve. I've tried. Sometimes I got the balance wrong, where I didn't see enough of my family. It's a great honor and pleasure to be on tour with my son, who you know, spent a lot of time away from me when he was very little. But he also came on tour with me when he was young, when he could, when he wasn't at school. So to share the traveling with him, to share a stage with him is fantastic. It makes me happy. I like to watch him sing. For me, it's a kind of out-of-body experience. I see myself, but something different, something better. So we've had a great fun together.
Oh, 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 you were looking for me, I was looking for you.
I hear a little bit of my voice in his, but also he has something that's unique to him. So it's interesting calibrating what he has from me and what he has from his mother, or, you know, what is completely unique to him. So it's a very interesting experiment. I'm very proud that he's taken my profession. You know, he could have rejected my profession altogether and said, I'm going to go in a totally different way, which I would have respected, of course, but I'm honored that he does that. I respect him greatly as a musician.
I was looking for you.
Elliot is my youngest daughter, and she's a fantastic musician and a singer and a DJ. She really has a lovely voice. Very special voice. I hear some of me there, and but also something unique to her. All my kids have a unique thing. I think the secret to success as a singer is to have a unique fingerprint, a unique signature that's only yours. And so that's what you try and develop. But I'm very proud of my children. It's the most comfortable place for me to be. It is my living room in many ways. Most days I have 22 hours of doing my routine, but then there are 2 hours where I really feel this is what I'm supposed to do. To be on stage, to sing, to entertain, to leave people happy, to leave an audience feeling satisfied and informed and peaceful. And so that's my job. I don't want to give that up, so I'll do it as long as I can. I'm completely in the moment. I'm not thinking about the past, I'm not thinking about the future, I'm just thinking about this moment now where I have to sing that note. And so in a way it's a kind of meditation, you know, in the past or the future, you're just here. Merci. Très gentil.